We have another useful component in Angular Material that is called chips. Here's an example. You've probably seen something like this in a lot of applications. We can use these chips as some kind of tags below an object. For example, we can add all the tags below a product, or we can use them to implement some kind of filter. For example, imagine we want to display the list of courses, and we have three categories: beginner, intermediate, and advanced. The user can click each category to see the courses in that category. So let me show you how to implement something like that. First, in app module, I'm going to import MD chips module. Okay. Now let's go to app.component.html. The markup to render a list of chips is like this: MD chip list. And inside this, we're going to have one or more chips. So MD-chip, let's say times 2. And now we give them a label like 1 and 2. So this is what we get: 2 chips with a neutral background. We can mark these chips as selected. So back here, for the first chip, I'm going to set the selected attribute to true. Let's have a look. So this is what we get. You can also change the color of the selected chips. For example, here I can set the color to accent. And now our selected chip is pink. Again, this is based on the current theme, and it can be different on your machine depending on the theme you are using. Now let's make this dynamic. So let's go to app.component.ts. Here, I'm going to define an array for our course categories. So categories. For each category, we're going to have an object with one property called name, beginner, intermediate, and advanced. Okay. Now back in the template, instead of hard coding these chips here, we want to render them dynamically. So here we add the ng4 directive, let category of categories, and then use interpolation to render the label category. Now, when the user clicks a chip, we want that chip to be selected. So we're going to handle the click event. And here we toggle the selected property of this category. So category dot selected. We set it to not category dot selected. And finally, we bind the selected property of this chip to category dot selected. Let's have a look. So I made a mistake. Instead of rendering the name of a category, I'm actually rendering the category object itself. So back here in the interpolation, we should render category dot name. And this is what we get. Now, when we click a chip, it becomes selected. Now, with this implementation, we can select multiple categories. But what if only one category should be selected at any point in time? Let me show you how to implement this. It's very easy. So, instead of toggling this selected property here, we want to call a method in our component. In that method, first we're going to deselect other categories, and then select this category. Okay, so let's call this method select category, and we give it this category object here. Now back in the component, let's implement this method select category. Takes a category object. Now here we need to deselect the other categories. So this that categories, first we want to filter them. We want to find the other categories. So C goes to C, not this category. Okay. So with this filter object, we're going to iterate over our categories array. And for each element, we run this comparison. If that category is not this category we passed here, we're going to return that from this filter. So this gives us the other categories. And then we can iterate over them using this for each method. And for each category, we're going to set the selected property to false. Now, if we set c.selected to false, we get a compilation error because this C object doesn't have the selected property. So we need to use square bracket syntax like this. Okay, now finally, we need to toggle the selected property of this category. So category.selected, we simply toggle it like this. All right, let's test this. So I select beginner, now intermediate, now advanced. And if I select advanced one more time, it's deselected and everything else works beautifully.